name is Charles Kettles, served in the Army for some 20 years on active duty, 7 years in reserve. I served in Korea and then got out in 56, came back, volunteered for return to service in 63 because of Vietnam. We owe it to this country. We had a distinct obligation to this nation, and we were not to shirk it in any way. In Vietnam, I served initially 1st Platoon of the 176th Assault Helicopter Company. Later that tour, I served on the staff as the aviation officer for the 1st Brigade, 101st Airborne Division. Second tour, I served as commander of the 121st Assault Helicopter Company down in the Delta. May 15th, 1967, pretty hard to forget a day like that. We inserted some 160 troops into an LZ landing zone. By the end of the day, we were down to 40 troops. The unit was down to one helicopter flyable D model lift type. I took that helicopter, was advised that 8 troops were still down in that landing zone against a battalion-sized North Vietnamese army in the hills. Got 8 men down there. You go get them if you can.
We have the opportunity, that's what we ought to do.
A mortar round went off the nose just after a touchdown and took out part of windshield left and right in the chin bubble, hitting a couple of those who had gotten on board. One of those troops got thrown out, caught the skid on the way out, and was pulled back into the helicopter by his buddies. Either 13 of us were going to be down there against the NVA battalion, or all of us were going to be out in that helicopter. And that's what happened. We got out. In just a day in the battle of Vietnam.
Yeah, that's me right there.
The credit doesn't belong here. The credit belongs with all those who were involved in that operation. This is the group that were with me on that day. How many did I save? I don't know. We saved what we could. This year I received the upgrade from the Distinguished Service Cross to the Medal of Honor. Well, this is the day, of course, that I received the Medal of Honor. It was certainly overwhelming. The award is nice, and I greatly appreciate it. What is really more important, actually, is the fact that those 44 are not on the wall in Washington, D.C. I want the youth of every generation to be taught on a daily basis the cost of freedom by those who have gone before them and the inherent obligation they have to help those who are around them. And you, as an individual, have an obligation to try to help. My name is Charles Kettles, and I'm proud to be nominated as Veteran of the Year